Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
My name is Dr. Muneerah Kuraishi. I'm involved in natural therapy, yoga, and oriental therapy from last more than 15 years. I have a clinic which is located here at Bombay Central, as well as in Bandra and Lukhinwala, Juhu as well. My purpose of doing this workshop is very simple. We have to invoke our energy or our existence as a happy being. If you would understand yourself as a happy being, I think half your problems are already solved out. Because has anybody seen a person who is happy committing a suicide, going for a depression, having troubles with blood pressure, or having any sort of a stroke? So when first thing as a human being, our first right is to be happy, right? And as we are on the journey to discover our happiness, do you think really at this point of time, being involved with the luxuries and the kind of electronic gadgets and the kind of influential, like, you know, lifestyle that we are living in, is not the one which really makes anybody happy? See, going to a dinner, an exotic dinner, may fill you for, like, you know, for the time being, but what happens usually after that? Tummy upset, late night, no sleep. Do you understand? So lifestyles or existence cannot be replaced with something which is known as your inner quotient of happiness or inner quotient of well-being. That can be only and only satisfied by one thing, that is your emotional resilient factor. In simple word, if you would call it, that is how happy or how emotionally content you are. Do you understand? If you look at it, like, you know, say about 10 years back, would you have seen, like, you know, so many cases of suicide among students? Say 10 years back, if you think about it, now you see 6-year student, 6th standard student committing suicide. I think earlier, 10 years back, the ratio was somewhere like 20s and 25 years. When you're going for a graduation, when you're looking out for a degree in an international college or something, a professional, like, you know, mastery, that would be the time that suffering or that solitude would make you so much rack your brain that you want to commit your suicide. But if you see that, 3 years, 5 years, 6th standard, 4th standard. How often you have seen cases or, like, you know, heard about things, 4th standard child, like, you know, just made, like, you know, had made a gun attack to the mother, to the father of a family members. Do you see? So see, the emotional or a journey of a human being is ever and ever going on. It cannot be stopped. And it would never be stopped. But the kind of deterioration as we see in our moral, physical, and a general value, whether you talk about your health. Now, dear, a person would think about blood pressure not before 40, 45. Why now 16, 17? You see college students drop down. Why blood pressure became low? So what is that? Like, you know, that they had so much. Okay, about 40 and 45. You see, many of your grandparents, 80s, 70s and all, no blood pressure, no diabetes, no obesity. 3 children, 5 children, cesarean, worked all over the life, no pain, no joint pain, no arthritis. What's the reason why, what is the reason which is making us so sick that despite we have the best of the resources? That time there was no question of organic food. You would hardly get, like, you know, food, something like after the guests are gone, the husbands have gone to sleep, the children have gone to sleep, probably you'll have it after 12, cleaning up all the kitchens and all. the husband, like, you know, when everybody has gone to sleep, just come, take the leftover and finish it up. Now we are having the organically grown fruit. We are having time to time. We are having best of the dietitians. What is the thing where, like, you know, disease like obesity, blood pressure, diabetes, or you talk about any sort of psychic attack, anxiety, okay, depression, tensions, then you talk about relationship issues. Why so much? The reason can be only and only attributed with one thing. Because we have become so much emotionally vulnerable. We try to compensate that emotional vulnerability with the luxuries or with the resources that we have. So what happened? One thing is replaced with the other, the second and the third and the fourth. The choice goes on, but basically there is a vacuum in your life. And that vacuum cannot be fulfilled through any resource except through your own understanding and your own catharsis about your life and about yourself. Do you understand? And for this, you don't need to go to, like, you know, fancy doctors or a psychiatrist or take medications or sedation or go for, like, you know, some holidays in Bangkok with, like, you know, massage parlors and things like that. Because the concept of health or well-being is very simple. When I look inside, it frees me from the pain. With the proper knowledge, I can keep anything, any disease or any problem away from my life. So you don't have to look outside for the resources. Oh, I'll go to a doctor, which is, like, you know, a psychoanalysis. He has taken his degree from, say, US or from Switzerland or something. You may just sit down 10 minutes per day in your own drawing room, bedroom, or maybe just, like, you know, a corner of a beach, or maybe your garden chair, whatever you are comfortable with, when there is nobody absolutely to disturb you, at least for a time period, maybe not say for about an hour or so, at least say 20 to 30 minutes, because then you would be in a process to recollect with all the past memories which has been, like, you know, either broken you down or which has been contributing to this present state of lethargy, sluggishness, depression, anger and anxiety. You don't need any monitor. Your monitor is your own heart. It will tell you whether the situation which was arise at that particular time, whether that was appropriate, whether that was truly your fault, or whether it was somebody else's fault. And always understand, rather than blaming somebody else, always take the responsibility for your own mistake. Because see, there's nobody on the earth whom you can change. You can change only yourself. So more you try to blame on, oh, that's the person who always makes me sick. See, he would always keep you making you sick. But the thing is that the more you think about that, the more he would do it. And as a process, today he makes you sick, maybe once in a while, tomorrow he'll make you sick each and every day of your life. Because you can't control anybody's thoughts or an action. You can control only your thoughts and your action. Okay? So first and the foremost thing that we would talk about or we would discover on this journey is how to still your mind and your body for a while. Now, have you seen this, like, you know, the episodes of CID and all? Have you seen any? I am sure everybody must be seeing, like, you know, that for a couple of times. What happens when they're trying to, like, you know, find out the culprit of a particular situation? Who could be? Kidnapper hai, villain hai, smuggler hai, murderer and all. what is the first thing that they do want to do it when they want to catch a culprit? What is that they do? Can anybody tell me what is the first thing that they do? Sorry?
They go to the police station.
CID itself is a police department, no? CID is a department of police only. So what do they do? If it's a police, it's a CID, it's a crime branch, whatever you call it. If you want to catch a culprit, what would be the first step of yours?
To analyze the modus operandi.
That would come later.
Investigation.
But how do they do the investigation?
And they put it on the photo letter.
That would be later.
They look for clues,
How can you? Come on, yaar. CID can't spread. I don't think that's really. How do you look for clues? They look for clue. And how can they look for clue? Now, there are, like, suppose the situation or. Yeah, tell me. How do they look for clue? See, the first and the foremost thing, they analyze the whole situation very, like, you know, methodically. And then, it's like you know, it's a, if it's a film, they would rewind it and look at it at from all the angle very, very slowly. Now, what happens? Nowadays, this World Cup is going on. Now, you are not sure whether this batsman who has been, like, you know, given ball, that's right or wrong. What do you do? You play the same action closer. So what do you need to do? You have to look at your own situation very closer, very slowly. You have to stop your movement altogether. See, if I'm moving out like that, you know, at a random, you cannot collect everything, whatever has happened. So first thing is that you have to slow down your speed. And after slowing down your speed, you have to look at all the circumstances which is existing in that particular, like, you know, situation. Okay, how far they can be connected with the motive of, you can say, like, you know, that crime. So suppose it's a murder is there, who is the murderer, who is the near one, what benefit he will get it. Okay, how it could be out, how he could be in, whether it's an insider, whether it is an outsider. Then they investigate, then they ask questions, right? To each and every person, whether it's he is being suspect or not, or, like, you know, suspected in the situation. So whether it's a right or a wrong, you have to count your life in a reverse order. And reverse order means you have to take those situations, especially which is responsible for breaking your moral down. In case you say, like, no, I am absolutely fine. I have a very loving family, a very nice working environment. I have no issues which are really, like, you know, meant in that way. I don't have any sort of anxiety attack. I'm a cool person and all. Fine. So if you're looking out even from the health scenario, you got to understand no disease arises because of the influctuation of your emotions also. Do you understand? So then also it has been, like, you know, connected. But here, since we are talking about the emotion, I would attribute more with the problems which are related with the relationship, anxiety, pain, suffering, schizophrenia. Like, you talk about any sort of psychic and the mental activity which is connected with you. Right? So way back somewhere in the 19th century, there was a person, probably it's a US scientist, which has discovered a technique which is called emotional freedom technique. Okay? This is a simple technique which helps you to sublimate the blockages or the energy pattern, the meridians which has been crossed out completely because of confluences of emotions. Or you can say the confluence of all your eruptions, vengeance, and then all sort of negative emotion that you have been suffering in your life. Do you understand that? This is now, this rank as the number one technique. I'm not too sure about India, but it's still in the Western countries. This is the number one technique for all sort of psychic, psycho and psychoanalytic missions. In India also, the topmost psychiatrists and psychiatrists and like the people who are connected with the mental health, they use this. But in US, if you don't know EFT, like you can't survive. It's been promoted on a huge scale. There are workshops, there are seminars, there are webinars which have been connected. There are courses which are only and only connected with EFT only. Now, how do you do it? Understand again, choose yourself a time and a period and a place where you are least likely to get disturbed. And after choosing that particular place, place yourself in a comfortable environment, neither too hot, neither too, neither too hot nor too cold, so that you can maintain that practice for a little while. Otherwise, what happened if the temperature fluctuation would be too much? You started, you're okay. But now suddenly the AC is, you have put it so low, you will start feeling cold. So, that would disrupt your practice. So, always do anything at a temperature which is suitable to your body or a little bit comfortable to your body. Is it understood? Now, after that, what you're going to do is, place yourself and maybe if you want, you can do it on a chair, you can lie down and you do it. But if you want to lie down, make sure that you don't go to sleep, right? And then what you're going to do it after, as you start your practice, you can concentrate on your breathing for a while or just relax yourself with a soothing music, maybe for 5 minutes or so. Or if you're in a hurry, you can start with it completely. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to practically demonstrate this technique. And you all are going to do it with me. 10 minutes time and you'll see how do you feel. First, close your eyes, everybody. If you're wearing a specs, please take it off. Everybody, please take off your specs, because then you are not in a position to exchange your energy completely, because that proves as a sort of obstructions. Now what are you going to do? It way down in your mind, just imagine and choose a particular problem that you want to get rid of, or the issues which is more important and you want to get rid of. Maybe time management, maybe sleep, or maybe whatever it is. Choose one issue for the time. Choose any issue which is right now very, very important and you want to gradually take this system, take this issue out of your life. So I'll teach you what way you can do that. Just close your eyes, relax your breathing, slow down your breathing rather. And after slowing off your breathing, choose the problem that you want to work on. As you have chosen this particular problem that you want to work on, I want you to place this problem on a grid or on a scale and rate it from 1 to 10. How far you would say right now this problem which you have chosen, how difficult or how far you will place it on a scale? Would you say that's 5? Would you give it a ranking of 5, 7, 10, 3, whatever it is? From 1 to 10, you have to give it grading according to the intensity of the problem that you're facing or how much it is affecting your life. Now I want everybody to open their eyes very, very gently. First, I'll demonstrate what way you are going to do it. So first see, look at it carefully, understand it, try to get into your head, and as you get into your head, try to start doing it also yourself. You're going to take your left hand, and with the left hand you're going to tap on the right part, this part of your hand, the padded portion of your, this part. So with this, we call it this a laser gun, the laser which will kill all your trouble, which will vanish all this. You're going to say, even though I have this problem. So instead of problem, you will give a name like sleep, laziness, not able to work on to issues or whatever, your cholesterol, your health, your cardiac problem, whatever it is, you have to precisely give it a name. Even though I have this problem, I truly and deeply love and accept myself. This you are going to say either 7, 9 or 11 times, whatever suits you. But if you said 7 over here, throughout all the points you are going to say the same number. If you said 9 over here, 9. Like whatever is one number that you have chosen, you have to be constant with that number only. So first you will do say 7 times over here. Then this is the center of your forehead, which is called your third eye. Here you would say the same thing. So this would be your first point. Second would be the corner of the inner eye. Third would be the corner of the outer eye. Fourth would be the upper lip. Fifth would be on the chin. Sixth would be here, the hollow of your neck. And seventh would be right on the center of your armpit. Okay, everybody understood? So now close your eyes. You all know the point. I'll be guiding you also. Every time when you say, you have to say with perfection. The only thing, the only requirement or what do you say, dedication you need is that firmness and affirmation to believe, yes, you can do it. And if you follow the right path with the right conviction, you would really find the things really getting dissolved. We have treated people who were going to commit suicide or who were under schizophrenic attack and all through this technique only. So it's not a simple technique, it's a very, very powerful technique. Provided you give it the full support, okay, yes, this is going to work and I'm see to it that I'm going to give my full effort for it. So come on, close your eyes. First start with left hand, make a gun and start with the right hand. 7 times, 9 times or 11 times. Even though I have this problem, I truly and deeply love and accept myself completely. Even though I have this problem, I truly and deeply love and accept myself completely. Come on, 7 times, everybody. If you finish up with that, the center of your forehead with the same finger. Even though I have this problem, I truly and deeply love and accept myself completely. Center of your forehead. Upar aur upar. That's it. With both the fingers together. No, use the both the fingers of same hand. In case you finish up that, you have to start with the inner corner of your eye, the right eye, inner corner of your right eye. Even though I have this problem, I truly and deeply love and accept myself completely. To finish the inner corner, you have to do it on the outer corner of your eye. The same eye, inner, then the outer corner. Exactly the outer corner of your eye. Face relaxed, no strain on your face, a very relaxed in a comfortable state, no strain on your forehead, no strain over your face, completely relaxed. In case you are done on the outer corner, then you are going to start with the upper lip. Start on this small indent which is there on your upper lip. Even though I have this problem, I truly and deeply love and accept myself completely. Finish up the upper corner of your lips, then down on the center of the chin, same thing. A bit more down. With the full convictions, the voice has to be strong, the inside feeling has to be very, very strong. No loose images about the therapy, no loose images about yourself. Firm belief, yes, I can do it, I'm going to do it, and it's going to work on to me. If you finish with the center of the chin, then the narrow hollow of your neck, what's called Adam's apple, the narrow hollow of your neck, where the neck is meeting your shoulder, that's right, the narrow hollow of your neck, here, you finish, no, here, in this gap, in this hollow, up. That's it. Yes. A bit more down, exactly on the narrow, what we call Adam's apple, the center narrow line. Yeah, that's it. A bit more down. If you finish with that, then the center of your right of your armpit, exactly the center of your armpit, armpit ka bilkul center, yeah, yes, come on, right, you can take the other one, how would you take the same finger, opposite one, okay, not here, center, upar, ha, yo yo. जो आर्म होल बनता है ना अपना शर्ट का उसी के सेंटर में अ बिट मोर अप नॉट सो मच डाउन इधर इधर थोड़ा सा नीचे दैट्स इट अप आर्म होल पे If you finish up, close your eyes, relax your mind, relax your body, and again, take that problem which you have chosen earlier at the beginning of the session. Now again, lay it down on a scale and grade it. Do you find any change in the scale which you have provided to it earlier? Earlier, suppose it was 7, do you find you would say it, now it's becoming lesser? Are it just the same or you find no difference at all? Give yourself a minute, take the whole situation, understand it, see the results, observe it distinctly away from the situation. Body has to be relaxed, face has to be relaxed, forehead has to be relaxed completely. The whole body, mind and face has to be very, very relaxed. Now if you finish grading it up, you can gently open your eyes, scrub your hands, place your palms over your eyes, press the socket of your eye, come up. Come up till the center of your crown, press it down firmly so that your energy enters properly into your body. Come down over your, press it down to make this energy more like, you know, coming and entering in a positive form. Scratch your forehead, come onto your eyebrows both, take it down to your corner, come up beneath your eyes. Lift your cheeks up, come on your chin, lips, chin, lips. Press your neck, front and your back. You can do it like this, whatever suits you. Now press your shoulders, press it firmly. Now come up on the yaw, on your wrist, press it firmly. Yaw. Now your fingers. Now you can press it again. This is a short workout, an acupressure workout which you have done to relax your mind, your face and your whole body. Okay? This, the entire technique has to be repeated at least for a period of 20 to 40 days to see the complete results for your problem. If you want 20 to 40 days, you will definitely find the answer for your problem. Sometimes answer comes like much better than that, much before than that. But in case you are getting the answer, don't get too much overwhelmed by the situation. Still continue. You know what happened? Now you are feeling very depression and very sad and lonely. Now suddenly you're getting friends, you are moving out and all. What happens after 2-3 days of that, good, uplift of the energy, then again it comes back into the same thing. So normally we say, even if you finish up, you tend to be feeling your problem has been solved, but still you finish up for the due course of time. As you have decided, whenever you start with the technique, always assign yourself a goal. I'm going to do this for 20 days. We say 20, no, we say normally 21 days, 41 days, like that. Because when you repeat, when you give yourself a time parameter, and when you repeat a situation or circumstances again and again, they get uploaded into your mind. And the more and more you are practicing it, the results get better and better. It's like your mantra. The more you recite, the more powerful become, because those energies help you. So the more you are repeating it, the energy pattern, the clearance and the upliftment of your channel take place. So whenever you're starting in a technique, whenever whatever you do, always set yourself a target. I'm going to do this for 10 days, for 20 days, for 40 days, for this. And then try to maintain that period or your target. No matter whether you finish it, suppose it happens after 20 days also, you don't feel you have really come to a situation or you have really got the answer for your problem, then extend it for another 20 days. But then probably what happens, you're doing it but you're not doing it wholeheartedly. Probably I'm doing this meditation, after this I'm immediately going for a party. So after all such practices, there has to be a little period in which that impression should be getting uploaded in your mind. Now you have taken a photo. Now it's wet, and you'll try to hold it up. What would happen? Nishan ban jata hai. Do you understand? So whenever you're doing a technique like that, you have to give some time off when you finished it up also. Uske baad aap immediately jaake kisi se ladne lago. You start working on your WhatsApp, onto your laptop and all. After this, there has to be a period of forces about 1 or 2 hours to finish up the whole situation. And if you do it, believe me, 10-20 days is never the thing. In any therapy, it's you just have to awaken your power. You have to awaken your inner being. And the results are much, much faster, much, much better than whatever you can think about. So I want all of you to start practicing on this. You all can take my number in case you all want. You are practicing it, and then whatever your results are, you can acknowledge me the same. So you can take down my number if you are going to practice it. If you are not practicing it, please don't take my number, because I am not interested in unnecessary calls. 7710. I want everybody to practice at least for 7 days. And then tell me whether you are getting it or not. 7710-86-5260. And my name is Dr. Muneerah Kuraishi. I have a clinic right over here next to Maratha Mandir. So anytime if anybody has a problem, a genuine problem, anything which is related with health, fitness or beauty, we tackle it completely without any sort of medication.
Yes, sir. we should do it with the right hand or left?
No, left. Left. Left with right. Because the left is sedating. It's like, you know, what do you say? Soothes with the right. Left finger you are taking and you're doing on the right. Because the left is soothing. Like, you know, it's decreasing, like, you know, that aggression which is left in, like, you know, oriental therapy. We consider the left channel represents your lunar channel. That is Chandra Nadi.
But I have got a sleeping problem. I'm feeling lots of sleep now. I feel really better.
You do that.
But I have to do it with the left.
Yes. Because that's what I'm coming to it. Because why you need to do it with the left? Because the left side represents to your Pingala Nadi. We say, like, you know, Chandra Nadi. Mm-hmm. The right represents Surya Nadi. So Surya Nadi is heat. Like when you want, you're doing the thing, but you're not getting the right impulse to do a situation. And then we say do it with the right. But since you have problems, like problems which are related with anxiety, pain, suffering, and general well-being, it is always advisable to do it from the from the left to the right.
So just go through it once.
See, this is the first thing. You have chosen this, and this is constant, this part. So even though I have this problem of insomnia, I truly love and accept myself completely. Even though I have this problem of insomnia, I truly and deeply love and accept myself completely. So this would be the first point, because this gives you the clarity, vision.
No, one.
This is always considered the beginner. Like, you know, this is considered the, you can say, warming. Okay, this is considered the first point. Okay, we do it like that, you do it like this, that's also fine. It does not matter. The point has to be tap. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here, center. 6 is here, at this narrow. And 7 is over here. Here, center. In fact, each and every point corresponds to a particular, like, you know, meridian also. Like when you're doing this, this is gallbladder, which makes your clearing, like, you know, your vision, your clarity of your thought. When you're doing it over here, that's liver. So that agitation, aggressiveness, like, you know, everything, anything and everything is connected with a meridian. Now, I'm not discussing it because the topic would be too, it will get, like, you know, very lengthy. But everything has got a systematically and a scientific approach of healing, because the meridian and the organs are involved. And whenever there is something, aapka liver acche se function kar raha, aapki kidneys acche se function kar rahi hain, so you are bound to get good sleep.
I've got sugar, I get lots of sleep, but today I have this problem, now I feel better.
Why don't you come down? You can come down any of these days. Usually evening is my consultation time. You can come down, say between 6 to 9 I'm there. We can discuss it. It wouldn't take more than 2-3 days to solve that problem. No matter how long you have not been sleeping it, you will find it very...
Sleeping problem
is sleeping.
I sleep. Over-sleeping. You are oversleeping.
Whatever it is, less or over, both are problem. See, sometimes people cannot sleep at all, and sometimes people are sleeping all the time. So that's what the problem is, the right. That is not a question of lucky. Sometimes it's very disturbing also. It's very. That's what I said. You calm down, it would be like, you know, completely taken together. And we don't give you any sort of medication or any sort of, like, you know, tests or things that.